Now, lawmakers from the Northeast have called on the federal government to take urgent measures required to bring an end to the continuous killings of civilians by terrorist groups within the region. This followed a motion raised on the floor of the House by Honorable Yusuf Yakub, expressing worry that despite claims by the federal government that the Boko Haram terrorist group has been substantially degraded, attacks within the Northeast on innocent residents and the continuous destruction of lives and property has continued unabated. Honorable Yakub says fresh and daily tales of war, maiming, killings and abduction has made residents lose confidence on their leaders. Other lawmakers called on the Northeast Development Commission to provide urgent relief for many of the victims of the insurgency and tasked the federal government to deploy more troops to the region.
The reality of the above must challenge our military to think globally on its war on terrorism, restrategize its tactics, and create room for more injection of men, materials, and ideas into the war. It is saddening, to say the least, to learn that over 300 insurgents that came on more than 50 motorbikes that had at least two insurgents for each and another 9 truckload of their fighters only met the feeble resistance of a handful of soldiers stationed in Garkida in my constituency last Friday. At the best of times, these soldiers are usually not above 100.
The services are out of idea. We thank them, they have done their best. When they came in, they came with strength, they came with vigor, they came with commitment to end this thing. But now they are full of complacency and they are out of idea completely. We know this and we are aware they are out of idea. So, Mr. Speaker, it's better we do something to save Nigerians or not. Next time, if care is not taken, a lot of honorable members on this floor of the House can tender their resignation, because as far as I'm concerned, I'm not comfortable. My people are dying and I'm here enjoying. There's no way I can take that.
In this very hallowed chamber, Mr. Speaker, honorable colleagues, we have discussed several times issues of security. We invited them here about 3 times. They told us all their narrations and they told us they are on top of the situation. As it is today, they are not on top of any situation, because Boko Haram can still come out to go and unleash attack.
Order, please. Order, please.
Attack on communities for over 8 hours. According to the story I read in newspapers, at the time they attacked Garkida, the battalion there had been withdrawn. By who? We don't know.
I want to amend the prayer slightly while adding my voice to all the speakers, because all they have said is the truth. So I want to add that the relief materials that Honorable Buba has so eloquently described to be extended to these people should be extended to the people of Gulde, Askra, Kurunglum in Chibok, and Auno in Borno Center.